Hey guys, Operator K here. So today I'm playing Kingdom Come Deliverance on PlayStation 4, and once again I'm joined by my green cheek conure, Duncan. So for today's video, I thought I'd start off with trying out herbalism, alchemy. So I just found this herbalist hut in the woods here, and inside there is a workbench that she's, I guess, cleaning, maybe watering. Really not quite sure. So, setups, I guess, pretty straightforward. Bellows, fireplace, some jugs.
Be a bit more careful.
Looks like some kind of grimoire. So, where am I going? Just bought a couple recipes, and I have a few other ones to try out. I already know that one. Okay. I have some alchemic ingredients in my horse. Not quite sure what I need yet. Expired salami, all this fun. And I have a little bit of my inventory as well. Okay, so let's start alchemy. Okay, so looks like I have water, wine, oil, and spirits. So I'm guessing that serves as the base. Vials, a still, colander, a dish, mortar. So a control for the bellows. Okay. Book here is recipes. Okay, so I don't really have any ingredients for these. I could probably pick up a few more. If you notice too, I haven't finished, or I still have a low reading skill, so some of the words are misspelled or dyslexically rearranged. Poppy, thistle, herb. I think I have enough for this. This is the one that's like a hallucinogenic. Need spirits, two handfuls of wormwood, handful of sage. Boil the sage for one run of the hourglass, I guess. Grind the wormwood, drop it in the colander, and Oko, cook, maybe? Two turns, distill. Okay. Let's see what I have for ingredients. Sage. Yeah, that's about all I can really do. Okay, let's start with spirit. Oh, cool. So, a handful of sage. And sure what type of time frame I'm gonna have once I start boiling it. Gonna do all my prep work. Okay, so let's start the bellows. Nice. So that's basically alchemy right there. Looks like you need help with something what I was talking to her before.
Is there anything I can do for you?
As it happens, there is. Drahamira, a widow from Ledechko, requested my services. But it's a long way on foot, and me with my back in such dreadful pain.
Guilt trip.
I simply can't face the journey.
All the way from Ledechko? What, they don't have a herbalist there?
They do, but she didn't want a local. She's a rich widow, inherited a butcher shop. You know how folks like to gossip, especially about anyone who's better off than them. Do you know anything at all about exorcisms?
Sure, exorcisms?
You know, banishing ghosts, smudging, spells.
A haunted butcher shop. One in a day's work for me.
It's not a task to be undertaken lightly. This is a real ghost. The spirit of a dead man who hasn't found peace. In order to banish him from the world of the living, you'll need to do a few things.
Slit a black cock's neck on the poor soul's grave?
What a despicable
awesome.
Thought!
Oh, well,
no.
Let's do that.
Do you know what smudging is? You'll need 10 poppies and some flowers from the deceased grave. Once you have all that, bring it to the house that's being haunted. Light it on fire, and the smoke will purge the place of any
yeah,
unwanted
spirits.
Yeah,
more than the spirits.
Sounds like fun.
Game.
I'll help you.
It's no game. It's a very serious matter. Drahamira was terrified. And these aren't forces to be meddled with lightly.
Fine. Is there anything else I should know?
That's a question for Drahamira. You'll find her in her cottage on the very edge of Ledechko. Take care.
Okay, let's settle up. Let's go home. Butcher shop, maybe? Yep.
herbalist Kunhuta sent me. I'm here because of the ghost.
You don't look like you know a thing about ghosts. Why didn't she come herself? Why
did
she send someone so young instead? Do you know anything at all about exorcisms?
I do. I can threaten her.
She was in too much pain to make the journey. But you can trust me. I know what I'm doing.
You'd better. Well, get to work then.
There's a few things I need to know first.
I'd rather you just got on with it. But I don't suppose I've got any choice. So ask.
What exactly has been going on?
It happens at night. Every night, now an apparition comes to me and I can't get a wink of sleep. I can't take it anymore.
Whose ghost is it?
His name was Alois and he had a farm not far from Ledechko. A few years ago, his farmhouse burned down with him in it.
I've heard that people who die such horrible deaths seldom rest in peace. Why do you think he chose you of all people?
How am I supposed to know? Maybe because we're neighbors. We grew up together as children.
I suppose that makes sense. Where is Alois buried? For the exorcism, I'll need flowers from his grave.
He's laid to rest in the Sassau Cemetery by the wall. His grave is a bit overgrown with vines. I've been there a few times for a visit. The first day he appeared, I prayed at his grave, but he came again just the same.
Okay. I know everything I need to know.
Then for God's sake, perform the ritual as soon as possible.
Look, the award for overacting goes to... Okay. Slefnir. Fast travel. Sweet. Let's see, type of route. So I'm really interested about this quest. For such a historically accurate game, with not a lot of folklore or anything in it, I'm really surprised to see a quest about exorcism. I'm kind of wondering if it's going to be like an actual exorcism or an actual ghost or just some kind of scam or like practical explanation or just like hysteria. Bad luck to walk a horse across graves. By the wall, but technically they're all by a wall. Ooh. Just encouraging grave robbing. Aww. No goodies. Flowers. Perfect. I gotta get rid of that shovel. There we go, I'm light enough to run again. And let's mount up. So, quick double check. I need to get poppies, don't I? Restless Spirit, collect 10 poppies. And to buy some from the herbalist.
Greetings.
Is there an alchemist at this town? Oh, I can't fast travel in a town. The shop might be closed. Feel like breaking in.
Good health to you, Henry.
Okay, let's. What, Duncan? And I fall asleep. Is there a herbalist here? Blacksmith, tanner. The lady said there was. Grocer. Maybe. Those two? To Ledichko. You sleepy, buddy? Maybe I'll get lucky and get an encounter or something on the way. End up picking up a new sword I haven't really got a chance to try out. Even the fast travel changes for night. So usually that kind of twisty path up on the opposite side of the bridge. Especially around nighttime, I usually get attacked by a human or a bandit. So, who knows? Maybe I'll get lucky, maybe I won't. They're all random encounters. I really question how necessary it is for my character to actually zigzag up and down the roads. of those one for a second. Even a random traveler would be different. It doesn't look like it. Jinxed myself. Sometimes the random travelers, it'll be like a knight or somebody selling a map. Mercenary, somebody you can fight, a guy called the Riddler asks you bizarre riddles. And almost there. Herbalist, or go pick some. Well, since it's an alchemy quest, I might as well just go pick some. Here. So this was some kind of mound. Just a little ways out of town. Like a hill or a mound or a burial mound. I couldn't really. There's these little interesting sites marked all over the map. Some of them you can find items around, other ones it doesn't look like you can. And some of them are just like a little bit of an interesting flavor. There's been like, it was stone or wood carvings, look like Slavic folklore. Sometimes an interesting sight, just like kind of a pot in a basket. It's like some kind of item, usually alcohol stashed in. I think I'm passing poppies all the way out here. To go to the mound. All the ways outside of town. Sage, why not? Quest, so theoretically it should be done at night. Still said it's easy to burn the house down though. Oh, for somebody who can't sleep a wink because of ghosts. or should I just torch the house? Where did the butcher go? What? Some haunted house. Shouldn't know how haunted it is by robbing the place. As much as I'd like to stab her, or punch her, something to wake her up. Let's wait till morning. Look where I'm going, miss. My house is haunted by ghosts.
I'm back with the incense. Can we begin?
Good. Let's go to the cross in the bedroom.
What?
I feel a bit out of my depth. This is my first time.
Comes along lip sync.
Well, get started. You've got the flowers, so it has to work.
Well, here goes. I command you to leave, impure satanic spirit.
What do you mean by that nonsense? Alois was an upstanding Christian.
I'm working here, don't interrupt. In nominate parties et filius... et spirits, etc. In the name of Jesus Christ, leave and never return. In the name of the Holy Spirit, may you find peace in the kingdom of God in the highest.
I don't know if I still have a torch.
Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. O Lord, may he rest in eternal peace, and may eternal light guide his way. Amen.
Amen.
I gotta get rid of that torch, it's annoying me.
Thank you. Please God, I can finally sleep in peace at night. Come by tomorrow to see if it worked.
Better have. Okay. Just gonna run to Rattray Mill or Rattray Mill. Rattray. Where did I even get that from? Forever time to wait. progression reading skill. It also levels up different stats and everything. Most of the books do. Some of them are just, I think they seem to be just historical background or... so yeah, so it's a easier way to pass time too, that it's something a little more productive than just waiting. And because the game won't let you wait, rest so long. Isn't that right, Duncan? Kiss? Okay, now we're not making out. It is a quest on alchemy and herbalism. And apparently seeing through floors. Hey guys, so just to wrap up today's video, I just wanted to see the potions that we were brewing earlier, if they actually do have a hallucinogenic effect as advertised. So I just kind of jumped ahead a little bit here, and I'm back in Rite. I went around a couple alchemists and rounded up a few extras. So if you notice, I kind of starved my character, so the nourishment's down to 14%. I tried this video a little while ago and had a problem where it didn't, I couldn't use all 10 potions I got. I was only able to take about 2 or 3 of them, so I didn't really get any effect. So I'm just going to kind of pound them in here and see what happens. I should be able to get at least 8 of them. So it does buffer strength. It looks like all of it there. So let's see what happens. So I am sleep deprived. I have pretty low nourishment. So I don't know what happened. Okay. Doesn't really seem to be much effect there. The inebriation's creeping up. Not really any sign of hallucinations or anything. What did that buff change to? Inebriated. Overeating, exhausted. Also says, bewilder your eyes with strange visions. He's writing a check I can't cash. Let's see. I don't know if this is just the inebriation or... Okay, this is getting harder. I'm over-encumbered. So it's pretty much total inebriation there. And I'm unconscious. And I don't know where I am. Let's get a torch. guess, because being drunk and having fire hand in hand.
Jesus. I could really do with some sleep.
Is this like a bird's nest or a pigsty? I have no idea where this even is. Skeletons. So I went back to my hometown. That's full of bandits. Burned to the ground. Wow. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna call it quits here. Thank you for joining me. This is Operator Kane Duncan signing off. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Later, guys.